We projecting Ghana and supporting our own. You're welcome to the Story Show. My name is Avila Demet for the UK's bestest MC. Our guest today on the show is D Crime. He is on the show to tell us his story. Welcome to the show, Doctor.
Doctor. Yes, yes, sir. What's good, my brother?
You're welcome to the UK.
Thank you.
And once again, Happy New Year as well.
Many happy returns to us.
Nice one. We're trying to project Ghana to the world and support our own as well. D Crime, we know your name in the music industry, but people might know D Crime, but not your story, as we usually say. So now that we have you on the show, your fans out there, people following you, they want to know much about you. But who is D Crime? What's his real name?
I'm here to do a rip rapper. Welcome your favorite rapper. You already know who's on the mic in TV, I'm a quaver. Microphone, share rubber. Roy, a pie, a plumber. Crime like a swag, and tell them I like a girl's penumber. Still your lady's lover, who with a baby's mama. Saka work for premium to some favorite mother. The emotion in Yamba, in my friend's your grandma. So twerk it, mama, same time, but I'm you mamba. Ooh, another banger. Chee, kasa, ma do mangwa. Me fans, mo who don't next up on me, drop your rather. So mojo, on saka. Now, me, don't say saka. What the money will tell me, papa, and then me, tree java. If I'm the deed to the crime, one time a cute, fair, handsome guy. Sometimes friendly here, yeah,
yeah, but I always represent Ghana, you know. I like to take Tema to the map, but of course, I take Ghana to the world.
And you're a doctor?
Me, a doctor. D stands for doctor. Doctor in the sense that I came as a remedy for the weaker people in Ghana. If you ask, I'm saying, I'm here, Papa, say, I'm here, Mr. Say, I'm here, say. I'm here, I said, you're here, 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 you're here,
you're here,
you most enjoy an acronym. That is at the end of the day, before I was starting, I knew definitely say Enyom and a mayor. And me being an artist, you know, that was the best thing I could just come up with my name. Because I could have chosen maybe excuse me to say fresh boy. But I said, ah, that's obvious. And I said, yeah, it's okay. So I said, ah. But then they said, crying, not here, definitely make you want to find out why. And see, that's how come I chose the creative one you most enjoy. It's an acronym, but of course, people know that I don't portray that criminal crime. I'm crime free.
Well, in case you don't know why Darlington is called Dr. Crime, yeah. I hope now you have a clear picture of it. Crime, we want to know the grassroots of you, where it all got started with you before coming into the music industry.
Yeah.
What kind of idea you were with your at all? So, when did you start school?
First of all, I was born and bred in Tema.
Yeah, you said that.
Yeah, my parents are in Tema, but of course, I mean, originally, actually, because my mom is coming from Akutia, and my father's from Bumfa in Konongo, Dumasi. So basically, I'm just a Ashanti. But with the music thing, I knew for sure that I was definitely going to do music because, you know, me playback. Let me say, if you fit in the family, I could be as a brunk and I'm a talk. And because you know my whole family, they were like people in the band. I know a lot of old songs from like the Kabobos to the Akusida Pons to the AB Crenzels and the Papa Yankees and the Kabobos and everybody. You know, and me drumming and playing their songs and everything, I knew definitely I was going to do music. Now, as late as 1998, I had my first line, first four lines, maybe it's an American time. But it was just first four lines, whereby I was in JSS by then actually. And you know, people kept being like, hey, that let me see.
So music has been something that, I mean, you started right from day one.
I can say that, yes.
So when you finished junior secondary school, what was your next step?
I mean, basically it's called basic school, and after that, you know you have to go to the next level. It's more like senior high, yeah. Uni and all that. So we call that just complex school, you know. After that too complex, we call Aswanzi Technical, Akara, Kipros. Let me feel about Aswanzi Secondary Technical. One and the other, finally, we knew. One thing I can boast of is like, and yet you know though, but one thing I can boast of is that anytime that I go to any school, I check them on the map like that. I think this is where my name, the general, came in, because anytime that I like to lead, not to rule people, but I like to lead, you know, put them on the map whereby anything that I do, I don't just think about myself. I think about me and the rest of the world. Because I believe that I can make the world a better place. Indeed, from Datu straight to Aswanzi Technical to Sutek to GIJ, Ghana Institution of Journalism and everything. They knew me for rap music. They knew what I could do. As a matter of fact, they could boast about me like, what's a rapper? Yeah, my boy really is good. And I was
going to Ghana Institute of Journalism.
Yes, sir.
So what was your rationale? Was it to become a journalist or... First, your reason going into that journalism?
Funny enough, before I even went to the school, I was already... doing the TV presenting and everything. And the TV presenting, it even started from my hood. I started with a phone, like, yeah, whatever, my name is D. Country, I'm here with my man, you know.
Snapchatting them, so, you know, and I was Snapchatting.
I didn't even know, before then, the connect was like, you know. And when I held the phone doing stuff like that, they didn't understand. But some people good next stuff, no more show, I was like, hey, man, let me say it seriously, you never come to me, you know. And I think that with that one, it was already prepping me to be the presenter that I could be. And see, Chen, I mean, you know, I had a slot on Force like TV. I was counting down videos from 10 to 1. But, you know, this is the line of music and my line of work. So, I mean, it was something that I'm a fan of. But it's still a great experience. People call me at the times to come present your stuff for them.
Now, what do you say with a very good English accent?
I think so. You see, you're probably going to be a teacher of YT. I mean, I'm going to be a teacher.
Uba butchering them, as some people will say.
I won't say that. I think it's a Wumba brochure that I will call quite a friend of a locally acquired foreign accent. But it's to call about one idea and also cut it. But today, make an accent. And only one aspect. But one thing I can say is that I like anything that I like to know, I like to know it very, very well. I like going depth of it. People call me the dictionary sometimes. I'm going to say, but I think it's about lesson. Anybody who wants to know, can get to know.
From junior secondary to senior secondary, yeah. Then into journalism.
Yeah, for sure.
Did you have at the back of your mind that you become an artist? Or,
I mean,
it's something that at a point in time in your life you just came to it. Oh, let me switch from journalism into music.
One thing I can say is that I've been doing this from like in collaboration until now. What did I make? It's not like after music, that's after school, that's when I had to go into music. Like I said, straight from junior high to senior high to tertiary, people were boasting about me, you know. By then, I didn't really to have my album out. The first time that I came out with an album was 2005. It was a compilation, Mile End compilation, where we had the songs like Ghana Mourinho and those things. We were the original recorders, you understand? But after that, that's when I kept doing music and everything. In 2008, that's when I originally released Kill Me Shy, and it blew up in 2010. You know, so that's like 2 years into those. And so then, before then, I guess, straight from the streets to radio to Dr. Duncan's show, Kasahari Level, me, Sakari Apono, and everybody were just working stages and other places together. I wasn't a super megastar, but in the hood, you know, they knew the general. They called me to my Eminem because I'm murdering you.
But see, the grassroots story about you that we want to know, I think, you're just brushing us through. But we want to know the in-depth story, the ones that we've never heard, the untold ones about Dr. Crime. Because of YouTube, we've got a chance to watch some of your videos before you became Dr. Crime. You in buses with Sarkodie, the Apollos, and other Tama guys. How was it like, just entering into the music industry? Was it something difficult or, well, we from Tema, we know Tema. That is where some people say that originated Ghana music. Was it easy getting into the music industry?
First of all, thank you for the question. You know, tearfully, I'm essential. One thing I can say is that Dr. Crime is a character. You know, he's a type of person whereby like he likes to portray something indigenous. He likes to portray something creativity out there. And but I say that one thing people keep forgetting is that he is still human. Most times people do things whereby they think like, okay, you're a D-Crime, you're all that, you got all the girls, you got everybody and all that. But if I tell you I'm Nashing, you wouldn't believe that.
That's a man, yeah. That's a wow.
It's part of the work, but I can say it's my target, you know. I know for sure that I have a huge female fan base, which of course I always am grateful and respectful for that, because believe you me, about a more pick than a woman. And one thing I have also come to notice and realize is that when it comes to my line of music, I might be a single person singing, but the girls or the females, they easily relate to it. They'd be like, oh my God, I wish my man was telling me this. Not because I have too much idea about love, it's because I could put myself into somebody's shoe to make it happen. Now, let me give you the likes of like Kum Kum Namaya, Kill Me Shy, Menewa and all them words. And then because of Mitorodum, Inti Namenya and Seven Saturday. But I'm feeling like, okay, at the end of the day, I play the devil's advocate. You mean the Akoswa Baba, but not for me, who you run for Buena Nation. I'm like, I'm not saying my bad for Kona. Like, I'm meaning not to say, like, I'm a man to Uncle Nubi. I'm saying, yeah, she said, what do you mean, Uncle Nubi? Uncle Nubi, I'm a Matia, so don't buy me. That means I don't know what you want. So let me check and say, ah, so I'm meaning not to say what? And you see with the ladies, these are the things they keep telling me, these are the things I want my men to be telling me. Like I'm saying, I'm gifted with this, and it's a God blessing. It's not because I'm too wise, or I'm Solomon, or I'm strong like Samson, or whatever. I think so at the end of the day, I take my line of work seriously. Now, we get not on channel, this is Dr. Crime. But sit down with Nagasol Tanahasi. He's a very calm, cool, outspoken person.
Wana woke up a calm, outspoken person. And I said, that is what the word say. That is what your fans say.
No, make I also deep crying, I'm willing for screen. I'm willing for new more to tonight. But we sit down with Nagasol will be in the inner part of me. Inner part of Nagasol said, I am a very calm person, free-minded. I easily make friends. The same time, most times, most times I am laid back. It's and all that. It's because of how scared I am that people get to know how free I am. Because if you were high, every time I saw I admire from far, but I know they're free and financial. I hear too simple, I'm nothing. Unless I trigger and I feel free. You know, at the end of the day, you know. I think that only the people who came up because me saying that the power of the impact of Babu. So, you are the friend that he and he was also a funny fool. At the end of the day, I think that this is the reason why sometimes when people might see me that I'm in a distance, but to bear me, I have to make it to me, but to bear me with a free power. Most times, some of you need them at all. Yes, I'm a reserved type of person. And only a Chrissy Ballantyne. And also, so Nantia, anytime that people see me, I can say, every person with whom you are, say, oh, crying. I mean, if you have a child, yes, you will be a child. Be
yeah.
Because I keep saying this, we know not to change. Maybe you need to say, well, I'll tell me how much I'm about. What's the next thing I say? I think sometimes people confuse artists and their personalities as well. You know, who will see you, so you're not a child, that'll be a child. And you're, ah. And what you say, real life in my family to
find a man. So, money, the money, I say, someone is mad at all.
I do so. And yet, yeah. I mean, what you see on the TVs or in the cinemas, you know, is an act. What did I make a say? At the end of the day, you know, and one thing I have to say, you know, is that, you say that they are already a man, you know, one or two, and all that, open man, it is easy, easy. This is what I want to give you
to them. Open
man, you know, and I'm a man. I mean, open man, yeah, my friends. Some of them, not all of them. Some of them. And believe you me, my fan base are like 1 million. I only know like in person. I could only say I know like bare 20,000 of them.
But see, am I how?
Then can I say? I think that they are trying to let me know how they appreciate me.
But is it true, sir? Am I pestas?
Criteria which is not so you know, if this is what they want. They hail it to their highest post. And we can kind of say that I can't imagine I'm a software. Because I'm also like, I'm a software. What's the effort? Say, I'm a semi ample. I'm going to put this or something. Right now, there'll be a cry title. I said, you're a pastor, you're the prophet. I can't be. But you say, remember, I'm okay. Remember, you're in town tough. Can't wait. You know, and it happens. It's normal because better for you. Or sometimes I think it's difficult for them to say. Hey, boy, if you know, and yet a bad thing, so like a bad man, my God, I get them. You know, it's an expression, it's not because they love the person. If you don't feel it, when they are now, you know, I told you, I tell you, if you cheated from a woman, I think I can't do my move, but you won't find you. Yes, if you are your pet, my girl was the last year, my little woman, like Lisa. I think they just adore our work, you know, our line of work. So, I don't know, I would share my mind.
When you made up your mind, said now, big crime, I want to do music. Did you get the support from your family? Your parents were doing in support with what you wanted to do because they'll be like, you know, Ghanaian parents. Ah, I was in school, I was so common, you know, doing the fashion, you know what I'm saying? Did you get their backing?
The beautiful thing is that my father has 4 albums to his credit. Yes, his name is Cully Hayes. Y'all can Google about it. C-A-L-L-Y space H-A-Y-E-S. Cully Hayes. And, you know, with him, if already he's doing music, he can't even stop me from doing it. And two, my family or my people, they're not like that forceful type of people. Provide an offer, as long as you're good to go. Leave your life and do what you want to do. Yeah, and for senior mama, I say, hey, can't you not share the person or your mechanic? And tell no one, not bad, I'm a pro. Beautiful man, all crap, pants, and a pants. It's not like that with my family. I mean, like I'm saying, provided you don't bring me a halal home, you're good to go. And, you know, with the support, I wouldn't even say he said, they started with like financing me straight and everything. I'm the type that I had to go get my stuff. I'm a go-getter. You know, I don't even remember the last first time which studio I recorded that I knew that I had a song. So at the end of the day, I fought for that. Whatever they make, catch an engineer, and I'm meaning anything. When guys like this got Google control, I said, this is my first single recording. I'm in at it. Like I said, I've been doing this like 98. You know, so forgive me that I can't really truly keep much of the record, but when I was doing this, I mean, I knew that I was just doing it. From the start, it was passionate, until later, you knew that, you know, the numbers kept increasing, like the figures kept growing and all that. And of course, we realized that it was serious business. Now we can't say anything again, because God, what it is, we can't be jamming people, yeah. But when I realized it was a serious business, you know, with contracts and everything, and the type of crowd and the people that I get to meet all the time, even with the kids, now I have to restrict some of the words that I say. So the business there is really a big business, but, you know, until you realize and really realize it, you might take it for granted.
Well, we're still here with D-Crime on The Story Show. I hope if you don't know much about him gradually, you're getting to know much about D-Crime. Let's enjoy this video. You're okay, Misha.
Yo, fellas, sing the song for the one you love.
I'm D-Crime, baby, baby. This is a song for my beautiful girls in the world. You feel it? You don't need to be told, baby.
Jeg står her ved det årlige Gold Coast Islands på Citizen Coffee for at byde velkommen.
Work in my tone, I'm a teacher, go cause you know you see them, they've got a course. And every time I go see your face, I would love to sing this song. Cause I'm only showing love. And if you told me, now I'm in my in the back of my room. Make me cry, maybe deep, maybe you're not a cow. I'm a son, 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 I'm a son.
While we're still here on The Story Show with D-Crime, we're getting to know much about him.
Yeah, baby.
Apasi, and Che, and I release it, do so. And I think that it's not only you in Ghana who has released similar songs. We have the South Cordiers and other artists who have released similar songs like this. What was your rationale releasing this song, particular one, to do so?
One thing I can say is that MZ Tudy Guy, you're taking me not too serious. And it's Doomso is one of the things that is really killing Ghana, but at the same time, the city is too crazy down here. And at the end of the day, you know, maybe beyond the make us get a bunch of chili or boom tea down there, what do you say? I said, Nane woke up to a Kotia Mwanda. Kotia, no, just a little bit of water, not to the mechanics. At the end of the day, you can't do so, no, you say, can you answer? But reality check, you read it, you say, and man, the movie. I'm a proud boy, you say, do so. But you say, on and off. Until I hear you do so, because I said, Pratrum, Bonda Kakira, you be doing into the man, TP, and Anquasum, Boka, perfume, Tula Lilka, and I have from the big shout outs to makeup, a man, a young man, a P, and Trim. For chicks, when you see the better hands up, what more am I legend to bankruptcy? I need a bad chick who can bad work. Next week, we could dinner birthday, Bangkok, dating. She's dating, well, I'm not. So tell me what's up with the handcuffs ahead of a freaky girl, you're a bad cop. Chabuko, don't cop. Probably don't come here and talk. And Nancy, I'm a real cop, don't know me. I'm a phone cop. Just about a kiss to my aggrep. That'd be sitting up. then you'll see anything goes. Just a hit you and find in a flat, because I got pros in different area codes. I'm not too many, you know, yes. Wrong hand cramps in a peanut,
right? I see you, with the big guns. But, you know, when you started, gay crime, the way you flow your accent, I've said it earlier on. What people thought you'd be the first person to put Ghana on the map as now we see in South Korea doing. Mm-hmm. But at a point in time in your career, gay crime was nowhere to be found. I hope you understand what I'm saying. Yeah. And not long ago, you and South Korea came out with a single, Coco Sakura, and people saying, well, gay crime wanted to use South Korea to relaunch his career into the music industry by the way. Why Coco Sakura? You and South Korea?
Thank you for the song. I mean, the first thing. Coco Sakura simply means porridge with nothing in it.
South Korea started from day one, but we all saw it. The crime, South Korea, Yafono, and a couple of other team guys. So, South Korea there. You didn't crack a bit, make a friend, you wouldn't have
it. Definitely.
Yeah.
One thing I can say is, Russia, one more example. You see Jay-Z, consistency has its own diversity. South Korea is good, but it's not globally known. Somebody might be in Ghana, his first time hearing. The same thing goes with D-Crime. Now, I keep telling friends, if somebody is your fan, you know the person inside out. But you can't love everybody. So when you are late dated about D-Crime song, it doesn't mean the rest of the world don't know. You understand what I'm saying? That is one. Yet to sum you, I didn't expect everybody to know me at once. Thing in India will keep building fan bases. To you, surprisingly, South Korea will be bigger than D-Crime. To others, D-Crime is bigger than South Korea.
Yeah, no doubt.
It is not just him. There's so many artists in Ghana. Now, when somebody says that you are riding on somebody's wings or shoes or, you know, whatever glory and everything, there's two sides to a story. It could be true or it could be false. That me, the idea behind me and Sakari's new song is because we are friends for long. We always work stages, but we never have song together. And it was just, it's funny.
Yeah.
Anytime that we go, we separately play our songs and the fans go crazy. But we don't even have a song together. That's how come we had to merge on that song. And it's just like, you know, on that song, we just went all crazy. Just like Superman and Batman. Or I could even say, like, you know, Spider-Man and Iron Man or something. You understand what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, it was a success. And that's the most important thing. Now, one other thing I can say again is that when you see, this is the line of music and this is the line of what we chose to do. People will talk.
Obviously.
People will talk. Now, remember, when they don't talk about you, you're nobody.
Yeah.
So when they talk, I accept and I understand. It means at the end of the day, we're going to be humble. So he who doesn't know, go online and check it out. The name is spelled K-O-K-O space S-A-K-O-R-A, Coco Sakura. Brand new D-Crime Sakura. It's on the second upcoming album. It's called The Gift Album, actually. And it's a 20-track album. You should imagine the songs that are on there.
How many albums D-Crime do you have to your name?
Too many singles, but I have one album.
Only one album.
Yes,
what was the name of the album?
It's called Finally. An album is not just me, my brother. You know, believe you me, when they say single, to even record, it's very difficult. So to come up with a compiled song, and call it an album is not a joke.
Yeah.
So the Finally album, that's when you had the likes of like Kill Me Shah, Manila, and
Wow.
The Wows and everything. Now, when it came to the Kum Kum Namaya and everything, these were all singles. I just gave it to the people. They had no album. Now, this is the second upcoming album. It's called a Gift Album. You've already enjoyed songs like Mook, Testimony featuring Stage J, Doom So. Now Coco Sakura, you should imagine the rest that are coming. Banger, Mad Flow, Creativity, and you would love it, believe me.
Have you ever won any award in your career?
A couple of awards, plenty of awards, straight from Ghana Music Awards to Golden Health Awards to High School Awards to
a whole lot.
A lot of awards, man. You can't keep track, you know. I think our awards are merits, and I always dedicate our awards to the fans because they've been doing a great work. And I respect them so very much, man.
Now we are in 2016. What should your fans anticipate from you?
Okay, thank you. Like I said, the second upcoming album is coming. It's called A Gift Album. You should expect that. And also too many collaborations as well. I mean, ever since I came to the UK, I'm doing a lot of collabs as well. Even not from here, just to get all around the world, straight from Nigeria and everything. And I believe in execution than just promises. So I believe that one day I'll stay tuned. You will get to see more. Now, stay tuned. I mean, I have different ways of you guys getting in touch, straight from Twitter to Instagram and Snapchat. The name to spell is Dr. Crime. It's spelled simple. DrCryme. When you follow me, you're going to be more updated. Make sure you being at home, don't be late dated. Because when you become late dated, you might be in 2015 while we're in 16. Shame on you.
Obviously, let's switch from the music industry to your personal life. Now, how old are you now?
I'm very, very young. Forever young. I just want to be forever young.
But what is your number?
Last time I checked the nap, or I'm checking something. But who brought it into me? You said, no, 2032.
You are not the only person doing this to me on my show. Yeah, look, Ghana, maybe I'm interviewing the piano. They try to run away from their age. You know why?
Welcome to Africa. We have two A's, you know. We have the football one and the...
So tell me your real one and the football one.
I mean, I just like to stay forever young. I think age is a number. It doesn't really matter, so I just like to stay forever.
I want to say, do you drink?
Not at all.
Sir, you don't smoke?
Mm-hmm.
Really? Because for what I've been told, mm-hmm. You see, artists, and some of the artists, before they go onto the stage to perform, I just say, you have to buy credits. Look at me, woman. Cast alcohol for now.
I mean, the main criteria of the digital subject will be honest and all your baby. I mean, start to get over. I mean, no man, I mean, shit. I mean, the minyane, no man, who are the men, you know. So at the end of the day, you are high and motivating. Me and you are not going to be doing that for this. If you are friends, you
are not going
to do that. Yeah, true. And see, I mean, me criticize you. But you are not going to be.
Okay, I'm sorry there. I'm sorry, man, I'll deal with.
The third method is our term of community.
Oh, nice one. I was saying, do you have a girlfriend?
We're dating.
You dating?
Yeah.
And see, London girls and what about, and say, you're being an argument, say, or be a person, you be a. I first say, now, no, they've got to know, say, I perceive it's gone.
I mean, I'm not here to say this thing to hurt any other person's feeling, but I'm still growing. You know, I'm a mature person right now, and it's not because I have. I mean, I know other people will lie.
Someone
will
say, Marpe, okay.
I don't know about me, I guess I'm in the middle. I guess I'm in the middle. I guess I'm in the middle. Maybe she means the song,
yeah.
Or the personality of the person, how he or whatever portrays. I guess I'm in the middle. So, like I'm saying, I mean, if I say that I'm dating, it's because, I mean, like, for me to be even more inclined.
I would say, finally, before we let go of you on this show, whenever you come on the show, we have final questions that we ask you before you go. Which is, you're going to tell us one thing about you that you've never told no one in your life, not even your fiancé, as you said. So one secret about Pastor Darlene Tim, D Crime, that the world doesn't know, no one has ever heard of it.
I got two things, actually.
Yeah. We're listening.
So one. Your queen. She's secretly calling you. But for some time now, because of my music business and everything, like, I've not been picking up, and I could see, I have to say this, I don't feel safe, because I feel like the MI6 have, you know, all ears and eyes on me now, like, they're watching me. That's how come it's been, like, for 2-3 years now, I haven't been to London, but, you know, but I'm fine, good, that's one, and they're touching me, and, you know, please don't, I mean, I'm glad that me and the cops have been able to solve all these things right now, but there was one time, it was late in the evening, straight from the studio, I was very tired, I was driving, and I hit my car, so then I had to come, you know, I mean, I reported myself later on, when I had to come check, and it was very unfortunate, but, I mean, like I said, me and the cops and the whole team have solved that thing, and the cop won't do it.
Thank you very much for being on the show. Finally, before you go, what have you got to tell your fans who are watching you?
Well, this man here is a great guy, you know. I like the way he say thank you and through and all that. It makes me, you know, that me feel like I'm didn't meet him about many times. But one thing I can see now is that y'all should watch out for the second upcoming album. It's called The Gift Album. You're gonna love it. It features a whole lot of artists on there, and you know, just feel creativity on it, and also same time, like I said, follow me up on all the social medias, straight from the Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat. It's DRCRYME, Dr. Kramer. I follow back, so just follow me and let's keep ourselves updated. And of course, 90% Ghana music, 10% foreign will take us higher on the map because we are trying our best. Even though God, we put God first, we try our best. He also help us do the rest. In God we trust. Peace and love. Yes, sir.
Thank you once again. Well, that was Dr. Crime on The Story Show. My name once again is Avila Demet for the UK's best SMC. A very big thank you to my manager, producer, and director, Fifi Edu, and my cameraman, Kwabena Kyo, for making this happen. Joe, Derek Moore, and NKD were also in the house to make this happen. Thank you for watching.
That's you. Yeah, come up every day, yeah, I'll come up. Came when in the cat, someone could eat, yeah, could you?